Hello, 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 hello. Good morning, good afternoon, good day, or whatever time na bisita po kayo sa YouTube channel ko. Kung bago ka pa lang po, thank you so much po for sharing, liking, and of course, subscribing to my channel. Yung mga nagbabalik na po dito sa channel kong ito, salamat po sa pagtangkilik. And I think this is my part 3 na pag-share related sa BCLTE October 2022. So, sa magti-take po, I think 5 days na lang po, and I believe ano ba dyan, ay ready na. So the rest, I want you to familiarize again with the following questions na ginawa natin just for you. So let's start. I think let's start with answering number 19. It refers to the answerability of every public officer whose duties permit or require the possession of custody of government funds. Ayan, ito yung matatandaan natin. Shall be accountable therefore for the safekeeping. Okay. So, marami tayong mga word na babantayan dito, mga answerability, custody of funds, and accountability. This is referring to letter A, that is accountability. So, this time po, number 20, it refers to the officer. So, inanap po natin ang tao na mag-handle ng ating custody or merong position of the government funds or property. O, sino naman po ito? A, auditor. B, accountable officer, local chief executive, or none of this. So, expected po that this is an accountable officer. So, 21, a written notification by the auditor to the agency head, an accountable officer, concerned with total suspensions, disallowances, and charge found in audit, as well as anong hinahanap, settlement, at anong gagawin. A, nagbibigay siya ng written notification, so ibig sabihin, it's expected that it's about a certificate. Ano yung hinahanap? Settlement and balances. So, it's letter A. So, number 22 naman po ay, ito ang tawag natin, that the disapproval, ito yung term, the disapproval in audit of transaction, either in whole or in part, is this what we called the disallowances. Next, for number 23, the persons determined by the auditor to be answerable for an audit allowance. Again, disallowance rather. Or, ang nanginahanap natin dito ay isang tao na nakikita, nababantayan po ng auditor na to be answerable for the audit disallowance. Ang tanong, sino po ang hinahanap nating tao dito? Siya po ba ang tinatawag na person of interest, person liable, person responsible, or none of this? So, I believe this is letter letter C. This is person responsible. Para confirm po natin yung answer key sa number 23. 23 is, oh, I was wrong. It is the person that is liable. Sorry. The answer for number 23 is person liable. Ayan. Paano natin mas madaling maalala ito between responsible and liable? Siya na po ay answerable for an audit disallowances. Yan na lang po yung alalahanin natin. That is yung pinatawag or determined by the auditor. Answerable for audit disallowance, that is person liable. Ito naman po ay answerable for compliance. Ayan. So ito siguro yung tinatawag nating person responsible. And this person is called for a notice of suspension. Ayan. So, balikan natin, answerable para sa audit disallowance, si liable po. For compliance, si responsible. Next, ano naman ba ito? The process whereby aggrieved party requests for the very officer for the modifications like that, the decisions, order, or ruling to review the same with the view of modification. Review. Rolling to review, yan yung mga babantayan natin, or modification, or reversal. So, the possible answer starts to letter L palin. So, do you think this is a resolution, reconsideration, recommendation, or wala talaga sa tatlo? So, basically, this is about reconsideration. And ito naman po, after the balance of an accountability of an accountable officer has been finally determined, the auditor shall compare such balance to the inventory of cash, ask them to ascertain shortages or overage. The following certification shall then be executed by the accountable officer at the back of what form? 70, 72, 77A, 74A. So, dapat mapamiliaran na po kayong lahat dito that the general for 74A ang ginagamit at sinusulat na po ng certification ng accountable officer na balance po ang inventory of cash and sa pabisita po ni old to, yan, if I'm not mistaken. Ayan. Sa cash count yata ito na portion. Pero ano natin, general form 74A, ano natin sa ating general form 74A, tama. And this time, we will be answering the question for 27. This is the obligation to prudently exercise assigned or imputed authority attaching to the assigned or imputed rule of an individual. At ang pag-usapan natin dito ay yan. Participating in organizational activities or decision, that is responsibility. Exercise, rule, obligation, then authority. Yun yung mga babantayan natin dito. How about number 28? The process of determining the status or balance of the accountable officer, settlement, reconsideration, suspension, or none of this. So, ibig sabihin, dinadetermine na natin dito yung status or balance ng isang accountable officer. So, this activity is called, para maklaro ko kasi nakalimutan ko na talaga ito. That is settlement. Yan. The answer is settlement. For number 28, settlement. How about this one? The determinant of action of law to allow or disallow the audit transaction pending compliance with a certain requirement, that is suspension. Then, tama ko, suspension nga to. Settlement suspension. Oh, yes. Tama. And the term blank, as used in the law, is the reference to a person who, by direct provision of the law or popular election or appointment, ayan, by the competent authority, anong tawag natin sa kanila? They are called public officer. Ayan. Ito naman po, 31. Maaring babalik ito sa exam this coming October. The memorandum shall be issued to the agency head and other officials concerned relative to the findings, observation, and the deficiencies noted in the audit transactions. That is what we called A. Accountant Observation Memorandum, B. Treasurer's Observation Memorandum, C. Auditor Observation Memorandum, or wala sa tatlo. Yan. That is Auditor's Memorandum. Auditor's Observation Memorandum. Or ito lang naman yung memorandum tapos observation. That's audit. Yan. And last, I think this ito lang siguro yung bibigay ko for number 32, that all transactions which are irregular, unnecessary, excessive, and extravagant, and those which are illegal and unconscionable shall be disallowed in the audit. Ano ang tawag natin dyan sa mga transaction na yan? These are ground for settlement, charges, or disallowance. So, I think yun lang po muna for this moment, for this time. Just want you to be reminded na ano na lang po, when you read a lot of, kasi masyadong madami talaga yung mga mababasahin sa LTOM or the rest of other references, mag-i-scanning na lang po yung gagawin ninyo, basa-basa, answer-answer sa ating mga, kung meron kayong makita or mabasa ng mga mock quizzes or questions na po sa ating group, FB group or FB page, sagot-sagotan nyo lang po para mas mapamiliarize po kayo. So, I believe these are also the item that we've discussed today is minsan din itong tinatanong, no? Hindi lang talaga minsan, kundi majority of the questions here that I raise or that I share, maaari din itong itatanong ulit this coming October 23. So, God bless and hopefully po ay may pasa nyo po ang ating exam na BCLT or Basic Competence in Local Treasury Examination. So, sa mga hindi pa po nakabisita sa ating YouTube channel, Simple na naman po, hanapin nyo lang po yung ating